Good afternoon, South Africa. Welcome to Afternoon Express. How are you, Pali?
I'm doing great. It's a Friday. As long as it's weekend, you know, I'm always thumbs up.
You're always thumbs upping it. Yeah. Well, I'm very excited for today's show because we're doing things a little bit differently. And today on Afternoon Express, we meet three-time Summer Award-winning music group DBN Nyts, who are famously known for their chart-topping hit Shumaya, which captivated your whole country.
Plus, we speak to South African poet, performer, and spoken word educator Toni Stuart, whose works have been published in anthologies, journals, and non-fictional books, both locally and internationally.
Yeah, she's quite outstanding. As we come to the end of Women's Month, please tell us what your experience of Women's Month has been. What has yours been?
Mine has been celebrating it with the team of Afternoon Express.
Yes, it was a big change for you this month.
My first month, and obviously so perfectly placed in Women's Month. Yeah. So this has definitely been my highlight. And yours?
Well, mine has been, apart from the beautiful women and talented women we've celebrated in the loft, I was so proud of South African women for starting this month with the national shutdown and just taking a stand against femicide, against the abuse of women and children. And I think that our voices have been heard and will continue to be heard.
Hallelujah.
So tell us what your highlight of Women's Month was and tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the hashtag Afternoon Express and pop over to our Facebook page and leave us a comment if you like.
And our featured musical group today, DBN Nyts, have 2 Metro Awards, 4 platinum single releases, and 1 gold album release. They're not planning on stopping anytime soon.
Yeah, and the year 2018 is set to be a game changer for the hardworking group as they are set on making an even bigger mark on the South African music scene. Let's jog your memory a little just in case you forgot how this music group took the country by storm. Here is DBN Nyts with hit song Shumaya.
Shoot, 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 Outing, touch is strong, see back.
Come on,
SAP.
Come on, say what?
Commander.
Yeah, say what?
SAP.
Yeah, say what?
Commander.
Cheers.
Abantu basekhaya, Durban Nyts indeed. What an amazing way to start the show.
What a treat. I can't stop watching these guys dance.
Yeah. I think it's obvious who are professional dancers and who dance just for fun. And you guys have made it so clear
are
professional ninjas.
Welcome.
I'm actually upset. No one told me about the white t-shirts. Here I am pitching up in a black t-shirt. What's going on? It's as if Bonnie is the real Durbanite and not me. I'm so mad.
So you guys started out as dancers and then you decided, you've got a handle on this thing and you moved on to become musicians and the whole movement grew. But you started out, 12. How did you?
Sindele Stimela. It's a long train.
Was it difficult?
It's the survival of the fittest.
I think we were the most passionate about Durban Nyts more than Abayama Chita. Because as about 12, as a Deben, as about 5, as a 3.
That's crazy.
So, Suganji, we went to Baninga.
And you know what happens?
As a represent.
Exactly. You just continue to represent everyone who's been part of you and who joins you, like us, as your fans, as your cheerleaders, and you guys are doing amazing
work. Being patient, consistent, to take you a long way.
It will, hey? You know what I mean? It will.
An example to other people that actually want to reach their dreams into the stage that we're into right now.
Be patient, inconsistency.
Stay in your lane.
It's like praying to God. Just pray to God and wait. Don't say, hey, God, you don't answer. No.
Patient. Be patient with everything that you do.
Doors will open at all time.
But I'm very curious because having 12 members of your group and now it's come down to the 3. How has that changed the way you make music? How has that changed the way you perform your music? Has it changed at all?
So what does Shumaya mean?
Actually, Shumaya, it's like preaching to people, preaching to people. Hello there. It's like tipping someone, hello there, wake up. It's like preaching someone that
hello,
you need to wake up.
Durban Nyts is here, and Durban Nyts is here to stay. You guys have had such international acclaim and have truly made a mark for yourselves in South Africa and Africa as a whole. Does that not add any pressure going forward of continue to bring out these hits? So what I like about what you said is that you guys are not letting the pressure eat you up. Instead, you're allowing that pressure to propel you to keep doing better and keep going.
Exactly.
Hallelujah to that.
Yeah,
it's amazing. It's amazing.
Very cool, Buffett. Yeah, album is dropping in October. We're actually working hard, eh?
Yeah. End of October.
I'm singing in Buzz and Nonk and Jaban Basse Teguin. What happened in Durban?
Now we're going to Mbuzo.
It's party wire wire. What happened? Is it in the water? Is it in the food? Once again.
Was it
Durban? I know.
What's this Durban vibe?
Durban is the Miami of South Africa. You know, that's where when all your bonuses have come in, you think about, hey, what's the vibe?
I must come to Durban, get that water in a bottle.
Yeah. No, you need to get baptized. Donny,
can I tell you, you need to get some of that Durban water for yourself, for your sons.
Yes.
Your household will never
be the same.
And already Ucebo has brought to light that you guys have your own company. How is that like, being your own bosses, CEOs?
Good, my challenge, but I think it's nothing, we're growing. And into senza ngesikhathi sethu. So uma sisivuka sense sifuna ukudropa ingoma nosibanibani, sithatha ifoni sibanibani sishaya ingoma. So I think it's better because now we do our music in our own terms.
It's that freedom.
Yeah, but si free nje. It's not ukuthi sasingekho free company, but sine freedom ukuthi senze umusic ngendlela yethu esifuna ngoma. Sifuna ivideo phezu kweplane sindiza siyayishaya leyo nto leyo. Akho ma restrictions.
Experiences from our background, previous company taught us a lot. You know, to be humble and to be focused at all times and know ukuthi everything come at its own time, you know what I mean? Yeah. And zonke imfundiso sithole kubona from the directors at Kalawa Jasmine, we actually thank you very much, you know
what
I mean?
Working.
It's just that our contract, you know, ended, you know, from Kalawa, and then we didn't renew, so we just chose to open another door, you know, for our actually moving forward.
And Oskido's been very supportive. He's the one who was guiding us, Oskido and DJ Bongs. They guided us into opening the company, what to do, paperwork, stuff like that.
Yes.
So, yeah.
Wow. Shout out to them.
Shout out to Bongs.
And also because you guys started out as promoters as well, right? So you know the business of this.
Brilliant. So you guys moving forward, what can we expect from the new and improved three-member focused Durbanites? What can we expect in the future from you guys?
Let's just say album for now. Dropping in October. Good music, good features, and more dance moves, and more connections, and more shooting beyond broad.
Yes.
You know, going to, we have our coming up tour, which is at UK, at Oxford Road. So
Tora.
You know what I mean?
And manja samba, so the samba no means the kwara.
Yeah,
you guys are traveling with Bongs, the legend. I am jealous.
Samba no
Bongs. Just came back from DC, you know what I mean? To go represent the trend. So shout out to DJ Bongs, man. Quara Nation.
Yeah. So are you guys sure that there's no space for one more and make it a group of four?
Group chat.
Yeah.
Number is about 10 and not 14. It's full on by
okay. So seeing that you guys are traveling with Bongs, have you guys practiced your Quara Quara?
From Kwasa Kwasa, from Itombolo, from Itualata.
You guys are taking all of the dance moves.
Are there any hopes to perhaps collaborate with other African artists all over the African continent?
Yeah, obviously we would, because we have a song, Assigns and Not Davido.
We're
also going to be working with who's this guy, Mr. Real.
Mr. Real.
The
famous song called
Yes,
in Nigeria.
Yes, Mr. Real.
So also, you know, in communication with Pato Ranking, we're actually going to do something with Pato on the releasing album that's going to release on October. Doing Africa from Zimbabwe, from Angola, from Namibia, from those are our places, that's home. We have our people that actually understand the reason why we are here.
Wow, that's absolutely amazing, guys. As your new title title single is called Sesi On. Sesi On. You guys are 100% on. Never to be switched off, honey.
Turned down for what?
Thank you so much for coming through. Can't wait to look forward to your performance later.
Thank you.
Yes. Thank you. So stay right where you are, because after the break, Chef Clem is bringing back those nostalgic memories by making a yummy corn dog. Express
yourself. Dumelang, Afrika Borwa. Spring is approaching with every new dawn, and so is Heritage Month. This Monday, the 3rd of September, we are ringing in both with Sesotho language radio station Lesedi FM. TV meets radio as the Monate Breakfast Show crew broadcast from our Cape Town penthouse to welcome the changing of the seasons. Join Mzansi's Feel Good Breakfast Show in celebrating our unique and diverse cultural landscape. That's Espresso, weekdays 6 to 9 a.m. only on SABC3. The stage is yours.
Good old-fashioned values and flavors you'll love. Celebrate the taste of yesteryear with Frankie's.
Welcome back from the ad break. You're tuned into Afternoon Express on this amazing Friday. My blood is pumping and I'm ready to get stuck in the kitchen. Now, Clover Frankies brings back those nostalgic memories and tastes of yesteryear with their range of drinks. And in celebration of this taste of yesteryear, we're taking it back to the days of the corn dog. You don't want to miss out on this retro recipe. SMS the keyword Clover to 33650. SMSs are 1.50 each and no free SMSs apply. Clem, honey, darling, yes, I have been wanting to learn how to make a corn dog from the days of watching those retro movies, and you get those carnival scenes and they're so romantic with the corn dogs, but I never knew what a corn dog was.
And I heard that you've never had one before.
Ever.
Okay, today's the day.
Today's my
easy.
Day.
It's very easy. You have to use a Frankfurter. This is Scavia. You can't use a Vienna. I mean, you can. You're not going to get the same experience from it. So Frankfurter all the way.
So what's the difference between a Vienna then and a Frankfurter?
Frankfurter is placed inside a natural casing.
Wow.
I don't want to tell you what the Vienna is. Okay, cool. Mm. But it's got that snap. Mm. But that's the thing. You got to bite into it. You got to be like... That's a Frankfurter.
Okay.
The Vienna's not going to give you that.
Yes.
So that's the first thing. I'm going to ask you to skewer the Frankfurters with the cocktail sticks. While you're doing that, very easy, watch your fingers. You got this, you got this, you got this.
If you go skew,
then kind of just like work it back out. It's fine. Okay. There's no wrong way to
do it. Until you get it right.
Here we go. Let's talk about in the batter. I've got some polenta. In America, they use cornmeal. So yeah, but yeah. We don't get cornmeal in South Africa. We do. Polenta.
So okay? Polenta is cornmeal.
It's the best next thing to cornmeal. Polenta. So cornmeal, a polenta in there, some cake flour, some baking powder, some sugar, and then you saw me add a bit of salt in there earlier.
Yeah, I did see a little bit of salt.
Egg, and then of course some clover, full cream milk. So how about you pour? That's the. Can you hear the outside there?
Yeah, everyone's getting ready for
everyone's
your corn
getting,
dogs,
yeah,
Clem.
Yeah, it's getting crazy.
It's getting crazy there now. We're all getting excited. How much
nice
water?
Thick,
I mean, how
like
much
that?
Clover milk do I need to put in?
Perfect.
Is that
you
good?
Want to get it nice and thick. Just like, I swear, if these guys don't stop outside, I'm gonna run downstairs and actually give them a corn dog. Bribery.
That is surely going to keep them quiet. For sure. So I saw you put sugar in this batter. Why sugar?
You want a little bit of sweetness in there. You got the salt in there, but it kind of brings out the sweetness of the batter itself.
Hmm.
So definitely. So that's why you add that in there.
So as you guys can see, the hero for us today is Clover. So if you want the link to this recipe and the ingredients list, all you have to do is SMS the keyword Clover to 33650, and this recipe will be coming to your device.
All right, then this is the technique. You swirl it through the batter just like that. Try and get the ends coated as well. Then you just use a spoon for that.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Nice. So we just need to make sure that it's evenly covered.
Absolutely, but I'm being so silly. My own hack I forgot about. Look at that. There we go. Can you pop it down? Nice and easy.
Because Clem, I got your back.
Here we go. That's all
you. All we have to do, instead of having to struggle with the bowl, you just dip it straight in there, get the entire Frankie.
Look how nice and coated that is. Okay, I'm gonna stay on this side of the pot. You can come in this side.
Perfect. Oh, I think I got too much.
No.
There's never too much.
Okay, so before you just drop into the pot, you hold it gently. Moms, this is for you or dads, not for the kids. And you kind of swirl it around so you set your batter so it doesn't just fall off. And then you can let it drop.
Okay, so it's safe to put the stick into the oil as well.
Yeah, of course.
Okay,
exactly.
Perfect.
So, go for it.
Yes.
I like this confidence. Here
you
we
know,
go.
It's Friday, okay. And I feel like I need to walk away from this week feeling a little bit more confident in the kitchen, and you've been helping me so much, Chef Clem. Thank you.
It's a
so
pleasure.
So I think I got this. I think I got this deep frying thing.
So once it starts browning up nicely, can I just say yours is 10 times better than mine? So
naturally,
you win.
Honey.
You win. Okay, cool. Nice and brown.
Okay, that's amazing.
But actually, let me take that out for you. You can point to the ones that we have on the side. So, I mean, I thought about Frankie's. I mean, it's so nostalgic, like flavors, like the original cream soda, which was clear, by the way, not green.
I wonder how they got it down to the green.
I don't know.
From a clear cream soda. And I've tasted this Clover Frankie's cream soda, and it is the
That's
bomb.
The real one.
It's the bomb.com.
There we go. Mm. And so retro, so diner style. I had to make something go with it. That's why the corn dogs are there.
What's the perfect dip for a corn dog?
I like mustard, like a nice... spicy, but like neon yellow mustard. That's not even yellow enough the way that I like it. I like it so much your insides are like glowing. That mustard.
I love
the carnival
that,
mustard.
That carnival mustard, that spicy mustard,
that's
the one
that
will give your corn dog the kick it needs.
There we go.
Hallelujah.
So that's all you. That's all you. And I know you've been taking snacks home.
Yes, I
have. And that no different today. That's all you.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Clem. You always have my back. I appreciate it. And I'll see you on Monday.
Maybe.
So SMS the keyword clover to 33650 for this Retro Friday recipe. And if you need to see how to make this again, just watch this.
Made with love by Clover.
So your corn dog dreams have finally come true.
Finally, they've come true. My dreams of meeting Durbanites have come true. Today is such a great Friday for me. I'm going to be fed and entertained.
I can't wait to see you bite into that corn dog. You've been dreaming about this moment for a very long
time. For too long, Bonnie. Thank you for having my back like that. You understand me. Yes. So now after the break, we're joined by poet, author and performer Toni Stuart, who is also taking part in the annual Literary Open Book Festival.
Remember to hit us up on social media and tell us what your highlight of this Women's Month was. Tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the hashtag Afternoon Express. We also have a Facebook page at Afternoon Express and comment over there. We'll be right back.
Good old-fashioned values and flavors you'll love. Celebrate the taste of yesteryear with Frankie's.
Welcome back from the ad break. You're tuned into Afternoon Express on SABC3, where the stage is yours. At the age of 15, she started writing poetry fueled by her interest in issues of social inequality.
Poet and author Toni Stuart has performed at the Paris Autumn Festival and is one half of international poetry/music duo Gertrude and Jemima with UK poet and drummer Remy Graves. Welcome.
Hello.
Welcome. Thank you for having me.
Just during the break, we were speaking about words and choosing words to express yourself. For me, that's right up my alley, but at the same time not. I don't know if I'm making sense. Being on TV speaking, you use words, but you use it in such a creative way. Why did you choose poetry as your medium to express yourself?
It's so interesting. I think poetry chose me. I was that kind of geeky child, always walking around with a notebook, writing whenever I could. And I think it's kind of ironic that I make my living speaking kind of and on stage now, because I was really shy and really found that difficult as a child. And I struggled to say those things that really mattered to me. And I found that when I wrote them down, I felt like I had a voice.
Wow.
And so that's really kind of where it started. And I was lucky. I had one of those. I remember there was this teacher in high school, my accounting teacher, funnily enough, who read my book one day and just kind of was really effusive and just over the top excited about it. And if I look at them now, I wouldn't look at them twice. But I think that encouragement is what kept me going and made me think, okay, cool, this is something that I could pursue and do.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And I mean, you collaborate with artists from very different disciplines. Mm-hmm. What draws you to that? Why is that important for you?
So coming up in Cape Town in 2003, 2004, I was working with Dial-A-Flat Music, based in Athlone, an independent record label. And they would host poetry and jazz nights. And so I was kind of coming up around people like Mac McKenzie, Hilton Shoulder, like, you know, and doing poetry and while watching them kind of perform and alive. And so I've always been in circles where there are filmmakers and dancers and theatre makers. And I think the beautiful thing about South Africa is that we naturally do that as artists. Mm. We mix, we share ideas, we come together, we find ways to collaborate. And because funding's an issue, we get really creative about how we work together to support each other.
Yeah.
You know, like I have a friend who's a filmmaker, and so maybe for the first time they might shoot a video for me, and then when I have budget, I'm going to bring them on board and pay them, you know?
Yeah.
And so I really like the conversation that happens, and I like how it makes me think differently as a poet, and it pushes me to be a better performer as well.
Absolutely.
I was about to lead to that question. Mm-hmm. Doing things differently through collaborations, how has it changed and affected your work?
Exactly that. I think the most recent, like a real big impact is collaborating with dancers. So I did a show with the Flamenco Dance Company in London last year, and I had to be on stage, and while I wasn't dancing, I had to think about physicality. I learned something about having eyes in your back when you're on stage, so that you're not just dead energy, you know, depending on where you're going.
Yeah.
And it's almost, I think, in a very personal way, it brought me back home to my own body. And I think as a woman, you know, and it's Women's Month, we're thinking about all of these things. Women went out on the 1st of August and said, you know, this is my body, I'm reclaiming it. And there are different ways in which we wrestle with our bodies, whether it's out in the street and the way that gaze is put on us, or the gaze we put on ourselves when we look in the mirror.
Or that protection that we constantly, that armor we need to clothe our bodies with.
Exactly.
For me, I mean, this might be a difficult or political question, but we are political, whatever, you know. Mm. Do you find that South Africans understand that a poet earns a living? That poetry is not just about showing up and entertaining people just because it's poetry. And do you find that you've had to educate people about the fact that if you need me to show up and perform, I'm an artist who is due her worth?
Definitely. And I think it's an ongoing journey. People like Lebo Mashile, people like Sis Malika and Ndlovu, they've paved the way for so many of us. And I'm all about this thing of the people who came before us. How do we respect what they've done?
Yeah.
And so they made it slightly easier for us. But there's definitely so much more educating that we have to do. You know, every month there are a few people who will email you and say, please, can you come do a performance? And then there's you have to find a really careful, gentle way, because it's the first time they're hearing it. This, what do you need? How much budget do you have? You can't expect me to do this for free. And no one asks a doctor to work for free. No one asks an accountant to work for free.
Absolutely.
And so there is a lot of educating. It does get frustrating. But I think the industry's changing. I think there's more scope. People like Koleka Putuma have kind of done a runaway, amazing, amazing job of showing that not only can poetry sell on stage, but that South Africans are hungry to read stories about themselves.
Yeah.
So it's possible.
Yeah.
And what we're hungry for on Afternoon Express is your performance coming up later, it being Women's Month, and we're closing off Women's Month with a bang. What is the poem that you're about to recite about?
So the poem is called The Revolution is a Woman. And I wrote the poem while I was at the African Feminist Forum in Zimbabwe in 2016. And the poem uses lines that women had, kind of phrases and words and ideas that women had been sharing throughout the conference. So I'd spent the time listening and capturing different ideas and things that women were saying, and then put them together to create this poem. And so I'll share kind of a short excerpt. You can watch the full video on YouTube. And The Revolution is Woman, that line was said by Miriam Kirolos, who's an incredible activist from Egypt and was really involved in the kind of activist movement in Egypt a few years ago.
Looking forward to that after the break.
Can't wait to see your performance. And of course, you'll be participating in Poetica at the Open Book Festival.
That's right. From the 5th to the 9th of September. There's a range of incredible events at Poetica and amazing women poets. You know, I know September, like Women's Month ends today, but there's some incredible women poets. Habiba Badaroon has a new book out. Philippa de Villiers is there with a new book. And then we have Babs Gons from Holland and Athena Farrokhzad as well. So really come out
and
support.
Sounds like some amazing women. Yeah, and the rest of the details of these performances will be on our website. So don't miss out. After the break, we are treated to a powerful performance by Toni Stuart. And remember to share your thoughts on social media and just tell us what your experience of Women's Month has been and what your highlights have been. Tweet us at Afternoon Chat and use our hashtag Afternoon Express. We also have a Facebook page. Comment over there. You can also call us live. We love it when you call us. We get so excited on 021-430-9881. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Get ready. The face of cybercrime is changing. And so are we. We are smarter. We take charge. We are in control. We are brave, innovative, everywhere. We are Sabric.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express, a moment we've all been waiting for. Toni Stuart's poem titled The Revolution is a Woman is a poem that uses the ideas and thoughts shared at the 4th African Feminist Forum, representing struggles and triumphs of women from all walks of life in today's society.
The revolution is a woman, reworking the histories that have shaped her, molding her violated waist into an unapologetic swerving hip, shattering the chains of her shackled ankle into a defiant, dancing leg, clearing the rubble under which her daughter's soul is buried. This work that breaks her heart, this work that feeds her soul. The revolution is a woman who speaks not only for herself. Hear her sing. This land is woman's land. This continent is woman's continent. We will never tire. We are proudly queer. Teeth biting back at the hands that would muffle her voice until she breaks free into a ceaseless prayer for love, an unending ululation for liberation. The revolution is a woman born into the light of feminist fires, standing in the flames of rage and love, burning tirelessly so her sisters will not die sad. The revolution is a woman fighting, loving, fighting, loving, fighting, loving for the soul, for the soul, for the soul of the world.
Come on over, come on over. Okay, I'm crying again. I'm always crying on this show. That was so beautiful.
Whilst you're gathering your breath, I hear that you don't clap, you click. Is that still a thing when poets are done?
It depends where you go. It depends what kind of events, what communities there. Some people what's click. Happening? Some people are like, in South Africa, we talk back. We save. We agree. We shout. We engage. So yeah.
Wow. I'm really moved by your poem and. I mean, many things have been said about revolutions, but never have I heard it said that the revolution is a woman. And when you think about it, it is the absolute and complete truth.
Of course.
No change comes without women at the helm of it. What inspired this poem?
So, I think, as moved as you are now, I spent, all this time at the conference. And there were over 160 women there between the ages of 18 and 80, all from the African continent. And I think, sometimes when we're fighting kind of social injustice today, we can forget that there are people, there are grandmothers who've been doing this work their whole lives. There are mothers who've been doing this work their whole lives. There are women who choose not to be mothers who've been doing this work for generations. And I was so moved by all of these different contexts on the African continent. Like the single thing that makes that connected us was that we were all women or people who identified as women from the continent, but they were all doing this work in their own communities for their own people, inspired by their own people.
And I'm sorry, darling.
I was gonna say I'm so inspired by you, and I know this is kind of shifting, but you won the Mail and Guardian Award for one of the most inspiring people. What did this accolade mean to you?
Yeah, the Mail and Guardian, the top 200 young South Africans, was it felt like a nod. And I think what it does is it opens doors and it allows you to get into other spaces that you might not otherwise kind of be recognized. And I think it was also special because that year there were so many other people, like very good friends of mine, who were also on the list. And so I felt really humbled and honored to be part of a community of people who were kind of also doing similar work.
That's beautiful, yeah. I mean, Women's Month is drawing to a close today, actually.
Yeah.
But for me, it carries on because every day is Women's Day. Every day we have to speak up on behalf of women, and every day our voices have to
get stronger. Though they quiver, they have to get stronger. What would you say to women watching right now? What's your message to women, just the community of women?
So Pumla Adineo-Qola has this saying, and she says it's about recognizing that feminist rage is as legitimate as feminist love. And for me, I think it's, you know, that's really something.
Yeah.
I think that sometimes we can forget that the tenderness and the love is also the activism. It's also part of the work.
It's also the fire.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. And that it's about how do we do the work where we are taking care of ourselves, like really taking care of ourselves. Like, are you sleeping
like
enough?
Like, for real, taking care of yourself.
And also, like, phone your sister, the one who's always strong. Have you picked up the phone? Have you checked in with her? Because the people who are always strong really struggle to ask for help.
I actually saw that on social media the other day, where it says, I'm too caught up being the strong one that no one is asking me how I'm doing.
Yeah.
So it's very important for us to reach out to our strong mothers, reach out to our strong grandmothers, our sisters, the bosses of our companies, the women in our lives that always have this strong facade, and give them their moment to be vulnerable.
Yeah, because as wrought as their strength is, as well versed as their strength is, that strength, also they use that strength to protect their hearts as well.
Exactly.
So it's in that protection of their hearts that they don't show their hearts and they don't allow their hearts to be
sued. And the work is about the heart, isn't it?
Yes, it
is. It's the fact that we love, that we are moved by things that are unjust. Mm. And so where's the space for that tenderness and that care for each other? Because sometimes it's a hard world and we all need that soft place to land.
Absolutely. Thank you for reminding us of that.
Mm. You're welcome.
And thank you for that moving, amazing piece that you just performed.
Absolutely.
Honestly, I'm sure everyone back at home is moved too.
Absolutely. Thank you both. Thank you.
Yeah, perfect. After the break, Durbanites prove why they are still amongst the best when it comes to producing authentic South African music.
On one, two, 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 and held, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Okay, perfect. So guys, so over there, we're going to have a
quick little
Welcome back to Afternoon Express, and I'm standing here with the legendary Durbanites. You guys are, yes. You guys are about to perform a song for us titled Sissy On. In my mind, this song says summer banger. It says club banger. What does this song mean to you guys, and why did you create it?
Actually,
it's a summer song to everyone. It's a shutdown year summer song. Yeah, it's just a summer song, you know, like this, you know, like this. It's a summer song.
What things are the
It's a summer song.
It's just a song to dance to, a song to enjoy summer with.
It's a happy song.
It's a happy song.
That represents color. That represent love, that represent everybody in South Africa. It's about someone that's already in the hype and happy and on, not off.
Yeah, well, I'm ready to get turned all the way on this Friday with you guys. Now, starting out in the industry as dancers, creating some of South Africa's biggest hits. Here is Durban Nyts with another one of their banger songs titled Sissy On.
Yeah, boo! Is Billy on? Raza. Is Billy on? I'm petty skims, I'm a better kiss. Petty skims, so kim, but to cream on ning, and I'm going with this. Even go sema cause bong, but I'm a king, I've been paying this. When I put good, I go from what is a miskim, I'm a sharing this. What about this? I'm petty skims, I'm a better kiss. Petty skims, so kim, but to cream on ning, and I'm going with this. When you want a picture,
like a celebrity,
we are the future. My singing never spot, sit as a god,
and you won't get a warning.
Who's up on a sissy on? Sissy on, sissy on,
sissy on,
sissy on,
sissy on,
sissy on,
sissy on,
sissy
on, sissy on, sissy on,
sissy on, sissy on, sissy on,
sissy on, sissy on.
Only who's the one kulala ngithole ma bang bang isikhiyashila khona ufuna ukubhaxa fast ngithi bang bang one ufuna ukungiculela wose bambi microphone ni mina ngichevele
watching you guys. You all have a very distinct style, but yeah. It blends together so well.
Hello, Dad.
Everyone has a flavor.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. Lemon twist, Fanta crepe, Coke, orange, and Sprite.
These are the naughty kids in class. You know those three naughty kids who sit at the back of the class because they know that they're about to get into a whole lot of trouble
in the right
with
man. Way.
And
course,
I'm sure your moms are watching, going.
Guys, I'm sorry. For me, it's the shades, man. The shades, and I'm done.
I need someone to go party with. I can't go alone, so I need to carry you. See how much it's concerned.
And Toni, did this song put you in the mood?
Oh yeah, man. I woke up feeling like I was gonna get sick this morning.
Yeah.
Me wanting to go. You've cured me.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for joining us today, guys.
Thank you very much for joining us, guys. Yeah. We love you all so much.
You guys
truly gave us different flavors on the show. As you said, everyone here has their distinct signature. And we celebrate you guys as is. Thank you so much for coming through on the last day of Women's Month. And thank you, gentlemen, for coming to celebrate with us.
With the Women's Month, Miss Caramel in the side. Hello, Dad.
Hello, Dad.
Enjoy you guys' weekend. Sexy on, Siyaqima.
So join us again on Monday as we chat to TV presenter and actress Nontle Tema. Plus, we have popular 90s American R&B group Drew Hill.
Have an amazing weekend. Happy eating. Good night and God bless.
God bless.
I'm a crossbow, I'm a king, I'm a big piece. I'm a tall and pogota, we flow, I'm a miskin, I'm a shaven niche. I'm a seven years of bed, I'm a petty skim, I'm a berry geese. Petty skim so clean, for to cream on me, and when it is.
Afternoon Express, made with love by Clover.
Another feel-good production.